and let's get this show started. Are you guys ready to start this show? Are you ready? Well, I apologize. I was a little late. I was back in the trailer getting my makeup touched up.
Ooh, about 8 years ago, I had an opportunity through a friend of mine, Todd Glass, another comedian, to start running a show on Thursday nights. And it was great for me because it gave me an opportunity to find a place that wasn't an open stage night. It wasn't that kind of chaos of an open stage night, a little more controlled show, but free enough to allow comics to flex some new material.
I can't even walk through a spider web without feeling guilty anymore. I just destroyed that dude's whole house.
There's a core audience that comes out to every show. Usually do 5 to 7 comedians. I don't look at tapes. I don't go out to anybody's open stage night to see them. It's all recommendations. So I started with people that I knew, and I was always like, hey, if you know somebody who you think would do a good job, bring them along, and we'll throw them on. We'll give them 5 minutes, and that's how we kind of bring people into the family.
Welcome. My name is Jim Daly. I'm a redhead. I know it's hard to believe, but yeah, one time I was a redhead. I'm a natural redhead. I got my red hair from a friend of my father's.
Maybe you guys can help me out. I'm married, and I've been having this argument with my wife for like the past year. I wanted to buy a MacBook Pro, a laptop, but she said no because it was too expensive. But then she wanted a baby.
I never thought I'd be a stand-up comedian. I thought I could do it, and then I took a humor writing class in college. Was awful, and I was like, okay, I tried. And then like later on, I just gravitated back towards it. My stage personality is kind of self-deprecating, overly apologetic, and nervous.
Like, I'm no prize either. Like, if you ask my friends to describe my personality in 3 words, they'd be like, oh, it's just send a voicemail.
I remember in grade school, we had to have little things that we exchanged for Valentine's Day where we'd say nice things about each other. And one of the things when I opened the slips was like, you think you're funny. And then I remember thinking like, I'll prove you wrong. People always have laughed at me because I do things my own way. One of the ones I always use was when I talked about something that happened when I was dating someone, and I said,
I told a guy that I owned mace, and he was like, why would you need mace?
So that was the first time I used my mace.
It's fun to take those uncomfortable situations that really are painful in the moment and just turn them into something for other people to enjoy later on. That's always good.
On the turnpike next to me was somebody in a smart car. Who wants that car? Like, are the people that are like, gee, I wish I could drive my dishwasher around.
Right? You find your stories, your niche, what makes you sarcastic, and you play with that, and hopefully the audience can relate to everything you're saying.
My next door neighbor has a grandchild named Lennox. Not only don't you know if it's a boy or a girl, you don't know whether it's a heating system or dinnerware.
They have people who really appreciate comedy, and Chris books comics that appreciate a good audience too. So it's cozy. They're right up in front. You like to see people's faces when you're performing because you know they're there. And you just keep working on it, keep working on it. And this place actually gives you the chance to do that too because they're very supportive. You know, you're not going to get heckled out of here. You know?
And I was diagnosed with anorexia. So I asked the doctor, where are you going to send me away for treatment? So he sent me to Old Country Buffet. I was in the back of an Uber pool, and he leans back to me and says this, I swear to God, he goes, my sister-in-law died today.
It's nice to come here and feel supported, and they're just happy to have comedy, and it makes for a good environment. There's nothing like getting those laughs and just feeling that pop of an audience. It's a high.
The best thing about stand-up comedy is getting to tell your story and then going to bed feeling like $1 million.